Hello and welcome to Excel VBA programming course. My name is Kazi and you are watching Excel 10 tutorial. I'm really excited to introduce you to one of the most powerful tools available in the Microsoft Office ecosystem, Visual Basic for Application. So what is Visual Basic for Application? Visual Basic for Application, also known as the popular acronym VBA, is an object-oriented programming language. Now, if you are not familiar with programming, if you have never written a line of code, if the term object-oriented is unfamiliar to you, that's totally fine. This course is designed for complete beginners. All you need is a little bit of basic Excel knowledge. Programming is the idea of giving a set of instructions to the computer, a sequence of steps for the computer to follow in order to execute some kind of task. When it comes to VBA is used to automate tasks in Microsoft Office application like Excel, Word, PowerPoint, Access, Outlook, etc. VBA consists of snippets of code that we call procedures or macros. Some people also call them subroutines, routines, programs, just different names for the same thing. But all of the snippets of code are just sequence of steps. Step 1, do this. Step 2, do this. Step 3, do this. Just like that. Imagine that you have a real life scenario where you want to explain to your coworker how to perform some kind of task in Excel, like modifying a daily report. You might call them over and say, the first thing I need to do is to highlight all of the headers and make them bold, then change the fonts to this font, change the font size to this, perhaps add a border at the bottom of the worksheet, etc. I want to perform a sum calculation on all of the columns. Perhaps after that I want to add a chart or a table or a pivot table, and then let's say replicate the entire process across multiple worksheet and multiple workbooks. The exact same way that you describe this process to your coworker is the exact same way that we are going to describe it to VBA. We are just going to use different syntax, a different language in order to communicate with the computer, but anything that you can do in Excel, in the main interface, you can tell VBA to do that with code. So what can VBA help you to do in Excel? Well, VBA is really great at repetition. It can help you perform the exact same operation on the multiple spreadsheet or multiple workbooks or multiple rows whenever you need to execute a repetitive sequence of steps. Let's say you run a report daily or weekly or monthly or every hour. Whenever you find yourself doing the exact same process over and over again, you can write a macro that's going to automate the process of completing all those steps in order. VBA can also help you to create a brand new Excel function to use in the main Excel application. By default, Excel already has numerous functions, but perhaps you need a custom function for your project or your business case. You can actually use VBA to create brand new Excel functions. You can also use VBA to react dynamically to events like user interaction. Now, what do I mean by user events? Well, imagine things like the user opening a workbook or creating a brand new worksheet or even entering or deleting a value in a cell. All of these things are called events. They shoot off at a given moment in time when something occurs. We can actually use VBA to dynamically read and act to those events to do something when they occur. For example, we can trigger a workbook to say whenever the user enters a value into a cell. It's possible using VBA. We can also use to render custom user interface. With all these things, user forms, and they resemble very much like a real life web form. While we have inputs, we may have radio buttons or buttons to click or a checkbox to check. After the user completes the user form, we can take the data that they provided and use it to modify the worksheet somehow. It's really great approach for reducing the total amount of errors that the user can commit and asking them to submit their data in a much more controlled environment. Finally, although it's not covered in this course, VBA can also be used to communicate between different Office applications. So for example, if you want to use Outlook, the emailer, to send an email to every single email list that is listed, say in a spreadsheet, you can do that. Although this course doesn't cover cross-app communication, as soon as you understand the basic of how VBA works in Excel, it's a lot easier to apply this concept to other Office apps and especially make them communicate with each other. So why learn VBA? Well, as I mentioned, VBA reduces the redundancy of your Excel workflow. Just about everybody uses Excel from time to time, whether it's a personal reason or for professional reasons like calculating your personal finances or even calculating sports statistics. Microsoft Office is installed over billions of computers worldwide, so Excel is a really, really popular spreadsheet and the most popular one in the world, I think. It's highly likely you are going to be working with it from time to time. So why not pick up a skill that's going to help you become more productive and more automated within it? VBA will grow your technical skills as a general Excel user and as a business analyst. If you have reached a threshold in your knowledge of Excel, if you are wondering what's the next best thing that I can pick within this application to make me more productive employee, VBA is undoubtedly the number one. There is no other tool available within any Office application that will give you as much power as VBA. VBA also offers excellent introduction to computer programming in a familiar work environment. Now, I mentioned earlier that you don't have to know anything about programming to start this course. If you are interested in learning programming for the first time and you picked up another language outside VBA, you usually have to learn a lot of things to get started. You have to learn the context in which the language operates. You might have to pick up a brand new text editor. It's a lot harder to get started something from scratch. The great thing about VBA is that most users have at least some basic knowledge of Excel. How we enter values, how we enter functions, the general purpose of a spreadsheet. And because you have the pre-existing knowledge, you have a really strong foundation, and a lot of the complicated things that you would have to learn in other programming languages, you don't have to learn here. You can just focus on the brand new concept within the context of something that's already very familiar to you. Finally, VBA remains a valuable skill in today's job market. Microsoft itself has said that VBA will be around in Windows version of Excel through 2036, that's 15 years from now. So this isn't going anywhere soon, and it's used a lot across many different industries, including finances. So it's an incredibly valuable skill that you are picking up. Now, as a general Excel user, I want to take a brief moment here to discuss the history of VBA. VBA is a modern dialect of a language called BASIC that goes all the way back to 1960s. The two are completely different languages. VBA is just inspired by the syntax and the logic of BASIC. That's what we mean by modern dialect. In 1991, Microsoft released the Visual Basic Programming Language for Windows. That's also a completely separate language that's used to build standalone desktop applications on Windows. So the important thing that I want to emphasize here is that Basic, Visual Basic, and Visual Basic for applications are three completely different things. In 1994, Microsoft released the first version of VBA, Visual Basic for Application. So again, VBA was inspired by Visual Basic, which itself was inspired by Basic, but VBA can only be used within the context of existing Office application. It can be used to develop something outside of an Office application. So both VB and VBA are inspired by Basic, but they are completely different languages. All right. So let's dive into the prerequisites for the course before I dive into the technical requirements. I want to really emphasize on the importance of participation and experimentation. No matter how many tutorials you watch, there really is no substitute for writing code yourself. You have to be willing to try out different things yourself. You have to be willing to make mistakes. You have to be willing to deal with the frustration of running into bug and having to Google it and reading responses on different social medias. And like, no matter how effective a course is, no matter how many video tutorials or quizzes or assignments there are, the single best way to learn is to try things out yourself. So this is the number one priority. So I strongly recommend, regardless of your Excel knowledge or your programming knowledge, whenever you watch a video in this course, copy the code alongside it and in your own Excel version. Make sure you are not just watching, make sure you are participating, and then after the video is done, try out something different. Try an alternative syntax. Don't be afraid to fail. Don't be afraid to run into bugs. That's the quickest way to learn. Now, as far as the technical requirements, you do not need anything. All you need is a working copy of Microsoft Excel. The good news is that VBA is already pre-installed in Excel, so a working Excel copy is more than enough for it. That's it, we are all good to go. Now, I recommend an intermediate knowledge of Excel for this course. I don't want to put any strict constraint on you. I don't want to say things like you need to know this function or this number of function or this functionality, because essentially all this means is this on viewer first time using Excel. Okay, you should have some familiarity with this application, what's its use for, common functionalities. You should know how to change the basic things like the font size, how to navigate across different spreadsheets, how to open a workbook and save them. That's it. Those basic common beginner operation should make this course very comfortable for you. I do recommend a general knowledge of really common functions like sum if, sum, VLOOKUP. This will come really handy. And of course, a little bit of experimentation with the things like pivot tables, charts, graphs. This will help you a lot. You don't have to know every detail, and I will be teaching those things time to time on the channel. Just subscribe and be in touch. If you have never played around with Excel features, I do recommend spending some time watching other videos on the channel before diving into VBA. VBA deals with interacting with a lot of existing Excel functionality. So if you don't know them, it's going to be hard to write code to deal with them. Finally, I recommend a basic knowledge of data types, so you should be able to know the difference between a number and text, or even some more complicated example between an integer versus a floating point number. The more data types you know, for example dates or booleans, or in programming terms things like arrays, the easier this course will be for you to pick up. Again, no worries if you don't know them, I will walk you through it. That's all there is to cover in this lesson. I'm really excited to teach you how to use VBA. It's one of the most powerful things you can learn within an office application to help you automate your workflow. I really hope you are excited as well. And in the next lesson, I will begin our journey into VBA by enabling the developer tab within Excel, which will allow us to actually interact with Visual Basic for application. Hope you are excited. I'll see you there. Don't forget to subscribe and check out the playlist. This is the official playlist where you'll find this course sequentially. Don't forget to subscribe. The next video is coming soon. Thank you.